episode of Super Reaction Bros. I'm Chris.
I'm Christopher.
And on today's episode, we're taking a look at the official trailer for The Doorman. Sorry.
Just looking at the door.
I don't know. Nod or something. Anyways.
You gonna let
me? I thought Christopher's already ashamed of me. So, anyways, it stars...
I've been ashamed of you.
It stars Ruby Rose as,
Starting on Ruby Rose.
Can we just continue with this without bringing this up? Please? Please? Okay. So, anyways, this actress stars as a former soldier who comes back from combat, befriends this family in New York City and stuff, but then something happens with the family, and if you've seen The Transporter, you know where this is going. Yeah, you know where this is going. So, yeah, she has to go save the day. Also, this film also stars the genre now. So, that's cool as well.
Look, let's get this going for the official trailer for The Doorman. So, here we go.
Of course, that's how you always kidnap somebody. Of course, he plays a bad guy.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, who are you?
I promise our visit would be as brief as humanly possible.
It's a cool fucking safe.
Forrest, are you there?
Inform me the building would be empty.
There's nothing to worry about, but has there?
Oh, ow.
What's a decorated soldier doing here as a doorman?
I'm sure you choose for music. I feel like I lost my brother on this. I don't know. Cause like
disco.
Okay, okay, regardless of our thoughts about her exiting the role.
The movie.
Regardless of that, I don't know. You know what? Like, it is a very textbook action flick. Very textbook by the book action flick. It looks in good quality, though. I'll give it that much. It does look good quality. Because let's be really honest, that last Bruce Willis one we saw, you know, wasn't great. But this one looks better quality than that. I can give it that much. But yeah, it's a very textbook, like, action flick, you know? They're trying to rob the place. It's kind of like that Die Hard-esque settings, like, and they don't expect this one person to be there. And in this case, this one person is a badass soldier. You know, so, John Renault, love John Renault, playing the villain. I think he's going to be probably the best part about this film, you know. Ruby Rose still has it, you know, overall, still has amazing, looks like really good fight choreography overall. I like this. It's nothing special, but yeah, if it's like on Netflix, it comes on Netflix or something, and it's just like me and our dad, and it's like, hey, let's throw on a random movie. Like, we did that once with this, like, Anthony Mackie, I forgot the actor's name, Frank Grillo movie we did, and it was like a remake, and we enjoyed it. So I think that would be a sin here. If it's like Saturday night film, you just want to throw something on, that's what this kind of film is. It just wants to turn your brain off and watch like a decent action flick. But yeah, that's my thoughts overall.
To me,
I feel like I should take shelter.
For me, it feels too... The hard part for me is when I see this film, especially... For right now, let me just, for this brief moment, ignore pretty much what I want to bring up. But it's the type of thing where she's a great action star. She can be a good action star, but it's a matter of finding those great, good roles that she can stick with. I mean, when she was in John Wick, I believe she was in the second John Wick film.
Sure.
She definitely did a phenomenal job, you know, performing this character. You know,
and she didn't even talk.
I mean, she barely even spoke or anything like that, and she did a phenomenal job. Here, you know, even here, it's like, okay, you know, it feels like we're kind of seeing where she wants to go with her career. She really wants to do more of these, like, you know, action-packed type films, but it's a matter of pinpointing what she wants. You know, it's like, which one's going to really land to get people's attention to be, or, they, you know, or is she just going to be those... one of those, you know, I'm going to be doing these B-list action movies, you know, these underrated type of films where it's like, okay, yeah, it's, you know, it's not big in, you know, in theaters, but it's like, hey, it's coming to DVD, you know, straight to DVD or on demand or this or that. So it's the type of thing where, you know, I think she could do a good job if she can find the right role, whether, even if it's like, you know, say if Marvel or even DC picks her up, even Marvel at this point does, then I would understand. It's like because of what she can do, capabilities, things like that. But, you know, for this film, I don't know. I think it would have to be a pass for me overall, only because it's just, like you said, you know, it is a generic type of action film. And for this, when I'm watching it, I'm like, okay.
And I don't think it looks bad either. I really
and
don't.
And I'm not saying it looks bad either, but it's for me, it's a big pass, only because it's just, I don't know. It just feels like there's nothing unique that really makes it stand out for me. Besides, you know, yeah, the action's fantastic. The action looks like it's being done very well, you know, with the hand-to-hand combat, all of that. But it just seems too very generic, like you said, by-the-book type of film. Because it's like I'm watching them, it's like I'm just waiting for Bruce Willis to show up at some point. You know, just for a cameo or anything like that.
No, we don't want Bruce Willis.
You know,
that.
But...
And apparently Bruce Willis only shows up in bad action films nowadays.
Yeah.
Almost.
Yes, but that's my opinion there, you know, on this film, because it's like, again, that's what I felt like, you know, because I'm sitting there watching it, and it's like, at this point, you can replace her with an older guy, and it's like, okay, so we're following an old veteran who knows his shit, you know, type of thing, you know, and to me, it's like, even then, it's like, okay, we've started seeing this so many times, it's like, you have to make it stand out. What makes him different than a typical type of action star or a typical, you know, character? And with this role, it's like, okay, it's... You know, you've seen this before where it's just like a basic person who's just out of the military, they're on a normal job, and then that's when they get involved in something. You know, and that's what I think of it. But besides that, like I said, that's what I think of the movie. It's definitely a pass for me. Not even a popcorn flick for me. It's more of a pass. And the only thing I have to say, I mean, I'm not going to blow up or anything like that, because some people know pretty much the whole Ruby Rose, you know, leaving the Batwoman role, you know, in my opinion, I think it was a horrible idea, but it's just the way they're handling it, I don't like it, but I could be wrong, they could do a good job and deliver a good story on its own, things like that, but that's just my personal opinion, I had to get out of the way.
So, other than anything we have to say about Ruby Rose's Batwoman, other than that stuff, if you're new to the channel, you can hit the like button. If you want to talk to us more about stuff like this, comment down below. If you want to share us around, share it around. And if you like us a little bit more than anybody else, when it comes to talking about action films like these, hit the subscribe button down below and hit that bell icon as well.
Let me make a whole video on that, but not now. Or ever. But let us know what you guys thought of this trailer overall. Is it something you wouldn't mind watching, taking a look at? Do you enjoy watching these type of films? No matter how many times you've seen this done before, but you enjoy watching these you know, low budget or P-rated type of films. Let us know what you guys' thoughts are on, you know, the actors are in this. You know, Ruby Rose, John Renault. I mean, let us know down below. Put down what you thought of our reaction. Overall, but most importantly, thank you for watching.
So until next time, folks, I'm Kristen.
And I'm Christopher.
And this is Correspondent Avery, Doorman Phil, episode SRB.
See ya.
Later.
Hey guys, thanks for watching.
If you want to check out our previous reactions,
or any one of our other SRB shows,
check out one of our playlists down below.
If you want to check us out in the social universe,
you can find us on Twitter.
And Stardust.
At Super React Bros.